Good morning, Hamilton. Today is Wednesday, February 5th, 2020. It is a day 4 on the day cycle schedule. We would like to give a happy birthday shout out to Charlotte in Miss Mogul's class and Peter in Mrs. Mustard's class. The word of the week is lackluster. He gave a lackluster performance at the baseball game until his family started cheering. Here is a joke for today. Why didn't the orange win the race?
I don't know why, Carson.
It ran out of juice.
Haha, good one.
Now over to Mr. Slesser.
Good morning, Hamilton. It is Wednesday. It is the middle of the week. Like that commercial says, it's hump day. So, let's make it a good one. Let's make it a good Wednesday. It looks a little dreary out today. It looks a little rainy, but I think it's going to be a good one. If you have a guest teacher in your room today, please make sure that you are doing the best and being the best scholar for your teachers. They are counting on you. And I think it's just fourth and fifth grade today. So make sure you're doing your best to be a leader in fourth and fifth grade. Teachers, Mrs. Garman is the only person out today without a sub. So thank you for your flexibility as always. Before I get to Judy Bloom, I want to announce some basketball scores from this past weekend. I know that the J-Hodge tournament is coming up this weekend, so that means the boys and the girls tournament, our season is coming to an end soon, but I do want to announce the scores from this past weekend. The boys A team played a doubleheader, it looks like. Boys A team, their first game, they lost 28-16. Boys A team, their second game, they also lost 37-24. The boys B team lost 19-11. The girls 3-4 team, third and fourth grade girls, also lost 24-13. But congratulations to the fifth grade girls. The girls in fifth grade won with a score of 30-16. Well done, ladies. So good work. It all gets, the real work is this coming weekend at the J-Hodge tournament. So give it your best. Be Hamilton Scholars and make us proud while you are out there playing. Now we will transition to Judy Bloom. Yesterday's question was, what was Judy? Nope, that's not the question. I was looking at the wrong day. Yesterday's question was, what were the names of Judy's children? And if you remember from yesterday, Judy's children were named Randy and Larry. This looks like a paper from my room. And this person got it right. Randy and Larry. And this person is Drake from my classroom. So congratulations, Carson clapping for you and Dominic clapping for you. Congratulations, Drake. Good work and thank you for participating. Today's question is, what was Judy's problem when she first started writing? What was Judy's problem when she first started to write? So listen up closely. All her life, Judy had made up stories. She told her children stories, and she invented stories for herself while she washed dishes or did other housework. It had never occurred to her that she could actually be a writer. It was time to try. Judy began to write stories for children. She remembered her own childhood in great detail, so it made sense to write about her youth. She wrote picture books and drew the pictures herself, though she didn't think she was a very good artist. Early responses to her work were not encouraging. Publishers rejected her story and book ideas. She showed her work to one of John's friends who had studied literature in college. He told her that she couldn't write. One publisher sent back one of her picture books with a note that said she had no talent and should just give up. So that sounds very discouraging for Judy. What was the problem that she was experiencing as she started her writing career? But I'm glad to see that she persevered because she is a fantastic writer in the end. So what was her problem? Make sure you get it into the bin today so that you can have a chance to win tomorrow's drawing. Again, let's have a fantastic day. Be a leader, be a scholar, show kindness, and show some creativity or be creative on your assignments and in the classroom. Make us Hamilton proud today. Have a fantastic Wednesday. Please rise for the national anthem, followed by the pledge to the flag, and let's have a fantastic day.